Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Amma ba'd, ayyala habita fillah. A fantastic treatise which we're going to begin, inshallah ta'ala, from beginning to end, which was by Shaykh Rabea bin Hadi al-Madkhali, hafidhullah ta'ala, which is a fantastic and very relevant treatise, relevant for us in calling to Allah Azza wa Jal, as far as da'wah ila Allah, because there are so many misconceptions about how to have hikmah and wisdom in da'wah. Allah has made it clear for us that we should call to Him with beautiful preaching. And the Prophet ﷺ illustrated for us and also detailed for us in many ahadith to have wisdom and to have rifq and lean, to be gentle and kind with the people and calling them to Allah Azza wa Jal. How would you feel, and do you think you would be accepting to the deen of Allah if someone is harsh and difficult and hard to understand and severe and stern on the people? But if you want to get your message across based on Kitabillah wa Sunnah to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the understanding of the Salaf, then you'll take the advice of the Shaykh, because he gave fantastic advice. And he began his treatise by saying, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. والأنبياء أجمعين وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this deen victorious through the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, who opened the hearts of the people with knowledge, guidance in faith, just as they conquered other countries with the swords of the truth. They used all that they were given of strength and wealth, as well as their own lives, in this cause. And because of this, they were able to accomplish the goal that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had intended for His religion, and that is that it is victorious over all religions. So the Shaykh is clarifying to us that the minhaj as-sunnah, the minhaj of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, is the minhaj al-haq, and that they were able to spread Islam through beautiful preaching by presenting the haq to the people. And this religion is based upon knowledge and guidance, not upon ignorance and desires, which was widespread in many countries in these, which is widespread in many countries in these times. They have methodologies that are not based upon the Quran and the Sunnah. Rather, they are based upon desires, except of course those whom Allah has blessed and saved to follow the correct methodology. The Islamic University of Medina realized this. It realized the state of these countries, and this is why they invite students from all around the world in order that they learn the correct aqidah and methodology, and then return to their countries and give dawah to it. So this is the function of the Islamic institutions, wherever they be, whether it's in Medina or other than Medina. Their intent should be to teach the Quran and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the correct aqidah, the correct creed, the creed of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, and the methodology and madhab of the Salaf. But it should not be to teach the Ashari creed, and it should not be to teach tasawwuf and things which are not from Islam, which are innovations, newly invented matters that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said regarding مَنْ أَحْدَثَ فِي أَمْرِنَا هَذَا مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ فُهُوَ رَدٌّ. Whoever innovates in this affair of ours will have it rejected. So we're ordered to follow the minhaj al-haq and teach the minhaj al-haq and be in the sabil al-mu'mineen. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.